I do not know a better name to call you. Maker of universe, maker of universe. I do not know how to explain you unexplainable, you unexplainable. Unexplainable to make all, yeah. You're indescribable. There's no way to describe you, God. Nobody can describe you, God.
Following the broadcast, and we know that a lot of you just watched and you don't respond. like to ask you, and I'm not compelling you, to make our something interactive. We know you've been blessed. So to some level, just respond as a way of you letting us know that you are collaborating with us. Yeah. We'd like to do that. So just before we come back for prayers, let's have Minister Paul get hand and just bless us in a mighty way. Yeah.
Life is all but nothing. You hold me all together. You hold me all together. For without you, I cannot move a mountain. My life is meaningless. Hallelujah. My life is meaningless. Say tonight, bigger than my life.
Greater than the greatest.
Oh God. Yeah. All power belongs to you. All power belongs to you.
All the glory is yours. You are the greatest. I don't know who else can be like him. Can you leave your voice and tell him this morning? Several reasons why I think he's the greatest in your life, and this morning you can say it. When it comes to your personal life, if you look over your life and see all the things the Lord has done, the many things he's accomplished, the many things he's fulfilled in your life, you got a lot to bless him for and tell him that he's the greatest. Several reasons why you can do that. Your family, he's kept your family, he's protected everyone else. Your career, job, provision, even in these challenging times, he's protected all of us. So he's indescribable. He's indescribable. He's indescribable. Yes, it's all. No one to come to know him.
Nobody can
describe you, God.
You are bigger than the biggest. You are greater than the greatest.
Maker of the universe.
Hallelujah.
You are
indescribable.
This morning,
Maker of the universe,
you're
the greatest.
You are the greatest.
This
morning, that's who you are. Somebody dance and worship the Lord with me this morning. He is the greatest. No God compared to him. No God has ever met. No God will ever be. He is the greatest. From beginning to the grand, he is really the greatest. Bless him tonight. We honor him. He is the greatest. He is the greatest. We thank God for Minister Paul out in this morning. Waking our spirit is the greatest. And I want you knowing that every time you come to morning dew, as you come in this morning to receive worship, word, prayer, and everything, we want you to know that he's the greatest. No matter how difficult, how challenging life is in itself, there's a great and mighty God who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can think or imagine. Yeah. So like you prepare yourself for prayers, now we're about to go to prayers. And we believe that it's going to be a great time this morning. So begin preparing your hearts. If you want to wake up from your bed, you want to sit up, you want to walk up and down, whatever it is, there's time for prayer. And I hope you know it's a prayer this morning. We're having a wonderful seven this morning. A combination of two wonderful ministers. They're going to be flowing with us this morning. Yep. Yep. We're going to be doing that. Thank God. Thank you for Paul Kerry Hardings. Yep. Bless him. Yep. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you, Jesus.
Went through worshipers.
Oh, we bless him this morning.
These are the days when my father's ways will be known to men.
Oh, yeah.
This is love when the Spirit gonna move again.
Yes, sir.
Sweet. For this is the time when true worshipers worship Him. These are the days when my Father's ways will be known to men. This is the hour when the Spirit's power will move again. As we were listen again, saints of God. This is a word of the Lord tonight. This is the time all over the earth when the true worshipers are going to stand and worship Him. These are the days when my Father's ways will be known.
Zabareba kusia baba baba raba kushike telaba. Zadele baka siki ya baraba kashiko tala bakasa. Mandoro baka shada, we come before you this morning. We thank you this morning. We praise you this morning. We bless you this morning. We adore you this morning. We lift your name in worship. We live in him in honor. We live in him in adoration this morning. We thank you for being our God. We pour our hearts. Pour our life at your altar this morning. We come to say we acknowledge you. for you reign from everlasting to everlasting. We reign as God, as the King of the earth. We bless your name. Let all the earth proclaim that you are mighty. Oh yes, as we worship you in spirit and in truth this morning, we thank you for strength. We thank you for grace. We thank you for wisdom. We thank you for guidance. We thank you for protection. We thank you for provision. We thank you for abundant supply. We thank you for supernatural interventions in our lives from day to day. We thank you for keeping us above all in these times, these challenging times, these confusing times. We want to bless you. We thank you for showing yourself as God, for proving yourself as King. We honor your name and bless your name. We worship your name and adore your name this morning. We shall take all the glory for the many things you've done, the mighty things you've done, the awesome things you've done, the glorious things you've done. We shall take the praise this morning. Let your glory be revealed. Let your presence be made manifest in our midst this morning. We thank you for everything you continue to do to keep us, sustain us, protect us, guide and lead us, show us the way, order our steps and direct our path. Your word this morning, O God. My arrow shabby and Zaboriba Kasia Nebaruka Shite Lereba Kasika Tura Buda Jarabaka Tura Bekasia Bene Mambo Rima Kashita La Baba Mambo Roma Kasaka Tala Baba 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 Makia Baba 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 Masukara Baba 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 Mambraka Shikata La Baba Baba Shabraki Yakasita Kashanaba Matura Mama Zabeka Talaba Zabeya Katuraba Jabroka Sika Talaba Jabraka Sakatalaba Matura Branaba Zabera Kashikaba Yabakata Jaburabaka Sakata Makatalabo Jaburabaka Sakaba Baba 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 Shakatara Bakata Zabria Kashikatara Baba Baba Makabaraba Jabraka Baba Baba Makia Baba 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 Mazokura Baba 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 Mashatala Baba 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 Mambura Baba 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 Makia Baba 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 Jabarabaka Sataka Shika Makabaka Sanabata Jabraka Shikatalaba Braka Shakatalaba Kasata Zanaka Sikatalaba Yara. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, we bless your name, O God. Oh, yes, we worship you. In spirit, we are in truth. Oh, yes, this morning. We worship you this morning. In spirit, we are in truth. Oh, God. Oh, Baba. Baba Reba Kasia. Oh, what a morning, what a morning, what a morning, what a morning. What a morning to be alive. What a morning to be in His presence. What a morning to partake of His glory. What a morning to experience it. What a morning to pour your heart before Him. What a morning to love Him, adore Him, to release yourself in spite of everything. Let's seek Him this morning. Father, we come, we seek your mercy. We seek your forgiveness. Wherever we've missed you, wherever we've not pleased you, wherever we've walked out of the way, forgive us, purge us hearts, purge our thoughts, cleanse our conscience by the supreme blood of the Lamb, O God. Renew our strength. Some of us are giving, some of us want to quit. Some of us, O God, want, O God, to throw in the tower. Renew our strength, restore our joy, quicken us, get us back on course again, O God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, help us. Help us to keep our eyes on you, the altar and the finish of our faith. You started this and you are going to finish it. You begin this and you are going to complete it. We thank you this morning. We appreciate you this morning. We bless you this morning and glorify you this morning. You reign supreme, O God. Oh, Shabbat Kabuya. Oh God, thank you this morning. Thank you for the blood. Thank you for your fire. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your grace. For your grace, your grace, your grace. Thank you for your grace. Your grace, your grace, your grace. Oh, the grace. Oh, oh. Mashkabarabana. Mama, mama, mama. Thank you, Lord. Present our day to you. Our challenges. Our needs. Our plans.
Lord, show me
the different situations that surround us. We present to you the things we don't understand. We lift to you. We pour out to you. We say, have your way. Show yourself strong. Show yourself great. Show yourself powerful. Show yourself mighty.
Show yourself.
Show yourself. Thank you. Thank you for that brother this morning. Enjoy my faith to them this morning. That brother. Enjoy my faith to that sister, to that family. Enjoy my faith. I hold hands to them in the spirit. And I pray for your intervention in every matter that pertains to them. Whether it's health, whether it's finance, whether it's trouble in their relationship, whether it's a problem with the children, whatever, affliction, whatever it is, I join faith with them this morning. And I believe you, oh God, for your intervention. I ask you to intervene. I ask you to show up. I ask you to turn that thing. Let it turn for a testimony. Every demonic invasion, every satanic infestation, we destroy this morning by the blood. We destroy by the blood. We destroy by the blood of Jesus. We destroy by the blood of Jesus. We destroy by the blood of Jesus. I lose your people. I break the chains. I liberate your people by your power, by your grace, by your anointing. Oh, Rabakashanda Bakatalaba. Divine direction. Uprooting of every stronghold, every spell, whatever. We uproot it and break it forth into a new level, a new dimension in you, in your relationship, in their dedication to your kingdom, their service to your will, in the name of Jesus. Let it not stand. Oh, yeah. We hear the sound for heaven.
It's the sound of worship coming from the throne. There are cries of adoration spread from every nation to every voice to make His glory known. Sing, holy, 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 this morning.
Holy, holy,
holy
God,
the elders and angels
bow to thee, worship God. Holy, 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 holy,
are you
Lord?
The song of heaven, sing it with me.
Holy, 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 holy,
holy. Oh, help me sing this morning. Help me worship him. Help me to know him this morning. He deserves it.
The elders and angels bow.
The elders and angels bow.
Repeat, worship you now.
Worship you, Lord. Holy, 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 holy Lord.
Can you hear it? It's the sound of heaven. In this place.
It's the sound of worship.
The sound of many waters.
Yeah, it's the sound of worship. Worship that is coming from the throne.
There cries of
adoration to man from every nation. To make voice to make the glory of
God.
To sing it
holy.
Well, the angels are joining, the host of heaven, the 24 elders, you and me, how you love me, the elders and the angels bow, the redeemed worship you this morning, we the redeemed, we say holy, 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 yeah. Are you Lord? Oh, somebody help me.
Join the chorus of heaven tonight.
Yeah.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy. Oh, we thank him this morning. We praise him. We bless his name. The elders and the angels bow this morning. Every day in worship in this morning.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, the elders and angels bow.
The
redeemed worship him this morning. And that's what we'll be saying. Holy, 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 holy. Can you lift your hands this morning to him and tell him, Lord, you are holy. We present our day to you and we thank you for being there for us. Thank you for your people. Thank you for everyone. Come. Thank you for the flow of grace. We thank you this morning. We just say we love you, Lord, this morning. Thank you for always being there for us. Thank you for being our help, for being our strength, for being everything to us. We love you. We love you. We appreciate you. Yeah. To look to your word this morning. Fresh dew from heaven. They pour in us. Let your word come with power and clarity. Bless and exalt you, Lord, this morning. Praise you. Take the praise this morning and may it be your name and glory. We bless and exalt your name. In Jesus' name. this morning we want to be grateful to the Lord and we want to thank Him. The elders and angels bows and the redeemed worshiping, saying, "Holy, holy, holy, are You, Lord." This morning, thank God for You. Thank God that You could wake Him. And the first person greeting Him on the as a blessed is a man who God is the God of Jacob. David said in Psalm 62, he said, "Oh God, You are my God. Early will I seek Thee. My soul long for Thee. My heart thirsts for Thee. In a dry and thirsty land where there is no water. To see Thy power and Thy glory as I've seen it in the sanctuary." Oh yeah. That's what David cried for. He cried for the presence. And this morning as you seek the Lord with me, let the presence of God take over you, your family, your home. Let every strange spirit, let everything not of God leave your environment. And let the glory of God flood your environment this morning. As holy, godly, you know, kingdom, anointed music flow in your atmosphere as you worship the Lord. And though you that were down, may you be lifted. And you that were guilty, may you receive freedom. And you that were dry, may you be revived. And may you be filled to the glory of God. I want to thank God this morning. Thank You. Yeah. We thank Him this morning. This morning we're continuing our studies in the season we've been teaching on. My season recovery. Yesterday morning we didn't go into the Word because there was a sense of glory of worship and ministration. And so we just continue in that flow. We allow the Lord to bless us and just minister to us in worship. Yesterday morning was an awesome time. And this morning we want to encourage you this morning. Daddy Leah, we continue today. Today we, as we continue in my season of recovery, like the Lord have allowed us to teach, we want to let you know that indeed God is bringing about a recovery in your life. And no matter what have happened, what you've lost, what have affected you, what state you find yourself in, recovery is your portion. It's an established truth. And if you know of anyone who you believe needs this kind of a message, let them know and let them begin to interface and get us on the morning and follow us and receive this word from God, because this word is for you. It's God's word for you for this season. It's not just any word. It's a special word from God to you for the season that will make all the difference in your life. And I want to encourage you to be steadfast, dedicated, and committed to it, and see God do all He can do in your life and bless you in a mighty way. You know. So I want you to say again to yourself, "My season of recovery." I'd like to go one step and say, "This is my season of recovery." And when we started, we talked about what a minor season and a recovery is. Talk about that. We talk about salvation being God's original, you know, a package of recovery for mankind. And we said when you get to know this, you know, it puts you above. Then we took time to talk about discovering. If you're going to recover, one thing you need to discover, and you need to conquer the battle of life and your family. And we said that we talk about how life has positive battles and negative battles, and we need to be concentrated and know how we can be able to take hold of the positive battle and deal with the negative battles. We talk about that. And we said if discovery will take place and if the battle will be fought, then you have to come to this to understand, number one, that you are God's deliverer. And we took time to share that from Ezekiel 22, where God said He looked for a man that was staying in the gap, and He found none. And I said that God has found you. God has found you for your family. God has found you for your generation. God has found you for yourself. God has found you for your nation. And God has found you for your community. And you need to understand that you are not just anybody, but you are this weapon in God's hand. You are this instrument in God's hand. That everything you see around you and that everything people are complaining about, and the belief is not possible, the belief that it cannot change, and your belief is remain constant. You are that one that God has raised up to change what cannot be changed, or what has not been changed, to bring about healing to where there have been wounds, to restore, to bring about the restoration of things that I got missing. Yeah, you are the God's deliverer. You are God's deliverer. And you need to understand that. And the sooner you know it, the sooner you discover it, the sooner you recognize it, you will be able to achieve God's purpose for your life. Yeah, yeah. You will be able to do that. You'll be able to do that. You will be able to do that. The sooner you do that, you'll be able to, the sooner you recognize it, you'll be able to discover. Yeah. So I want to encourage you this morning, as we walk with, as we seek God, I want you to know that that is the best that could ever happen in your life. And I want to encourage you to take advantage of the glory of God. This morning, we want to continue under discovering and conquering the battles of life or of your family. We say that about the first one, we talk about you should know. Some of you need to discover. I know that there's a pattern that happens. And you know, this thing happens consistently in my life. This thing took place. That thing took place. This thing is an obstacle. This thing is a barrier. It's a barrier to this family. It's a barrier to me. It's a barrier to that. And you begin to recognize this is the thing that won't let us be happy. This thing that won't allow our marriage to work. This thing that won't allow our business to succeed. This thing that won't allow so and so thing to take place. And then you propose that, hey, I'm going to take actions that will resolve this. That will make sure that this thing, because whenever a problem is presenting itself, there is a solution to that problem. So you can look at the problem and give up on the problem, or you can see the problem as a challenge and begin to look at the solution. Sometimes the solution is within your purview. That means you have access to it. You can either get it by book, you can get it by obtaining my money, by whatever, or by information. Sometimes the solution is not with the solution with someone. Now, if the solution is with someone, then you need to build a network. You need to build a relationship. You need to see how you can find yourself into that particular kind of a network and connection that will be able to offer the kind of a solution that you desire. Like, for example, all right, you may be listening to me right now, this morning, and the thing I'm teaching has a way of helping you, has a way of changing the situation around you, all right? Let's look at the situation. Let's look at the prodigal son, for example, that we spoke about the other night. The prodigal son, the Bible says that the prodigal son recovered. He recovered from the damage and the catastrophe he created for himself. He could recover. How did he recover? He recovered when he came to himself. How did he come to himself? I believe he sat down and did some deep thinking and did some evaluation. That's what we say here. Know the challenges. All right, I'm faced with this. I'm eating with pigs. Why am I eating with pigs? And he said to himself, I think I owe this to myself. I think I've been ungrateful. I think I made some premature decisions. I think I acted foolishness. I believe I did this, I did that. And when he sat down and came up with all those different things, and that's when you follow our Better Life broadcast, that is every evening at 8 o'clock, you'll find out that we're talking that about the power of great, the power of the power and the benefit of great decisions. So he sat down and he came up with some analysis. He looked at the issue from a realistic point of view. Look at it. He didn't delude himself. He looked at the issues and said, This is what's happening. I took this action. I should not have taken this action. I did this. I was not supposed to do this. Many times people don't recover because they are not prepared to face the challenges. They're not prepared to realize. I remember when David had a problem and he messed up with Bathsheba and scattered himself and dismantled things. And when David went before God in Psalm 51, he said, God, only against you have I sinned. He didn't go and say, oh, God, you know, it will be I'm not talking about that belly. The woman taken by that. I don't know what the woman desire to take by at that time. You see, now you're not looking at the reality. You're talking about what the woman would go take by at that time, what the woman had to do. It had nothing to do with that. It had to do with his personal disease. God, only against you have I sinned. And there are some of us today, there are things that have happened to us. And the reason why we are staying in those things is because we have not been able to face the challenges. We have not been able to look at the thing and evaluate it and do details, understand concerning it and take responsibility where we're supposed to take responsibility and learn the lessons. Sometimes some things we go through in life and to learn certain lessons. So the Bible says when he came to himself, because when he was with his father, there are too many things he never appreciated. When he was with his father, there are too many things he never recognized. But his eyes were only getting his inheritance and hoping. That's why by the time they gave him his inheritance, he asked where he was gone. And the Bible says when he wasted, and then he started messing, then he said, why should my life be going through this? He said, even a servant in my father's house does not experience this. That was the beginning of his recovery. The recovery started with some deep thinking. Deep analyzing, deep considerations. He said, even a servant of my father doesn't experience this. How? Here I'm a servant, and my life is worse than anything. He said, you know what I mean? Though over there I was a son, but I preferred to go back to my house and be servant. Because a servant in my father's house will live better than a servant one here. So I'm chosen, that I'm going back to my father's house, and I'm going to be a servant. That means his desire and his decision, the solving of the problem was that he was not even prepared to be son any longer. He was ready to even go through the humility. He was ready to go through anything would cause him just to be a servant in his father's house and not go through the things he was going through. Sometimes our recovery will require us to put aside our pride, to put aside our deception, to put aside our illusion, false thinkings and false mentalities of ourselves. We put aside our arrogance. It will require us to be real. It will require us respecting people. It will require working on ourselves. You understand what I'm saying? Dealing with things in our life that stands as a hindrance, that causes us not to maintain the blessings God gives us. Yes, it will require that. It will require it. It required it. He came to himself. He had to put those things aside. Oh yes. He had to put it aside. And when he did that, the recovery began. Now in his mind, the way he had messed things up, if he went back to his father's house, he would not be taken as a son. But he said, even if I cannot be a son, I'll be a servant in my father's house. I prefer that one. And guess what? As he won his way back, instead of being received as a servant, he received his sonship back with honor, with elevation, with promotion, with everything. I'm sure he was shocked. But what led to that recovery? What led to that recovery? You know? What led to that recovery?
Let's look up the book of Luke. Oh, yes. The book of Luke. Let's look up. Let's look at something in there.
Luke.
The book of Luke. Let's go to Luke chapter 15 and 15, begin at 11. Is it 15 begin at 11 or 11 begin at 15? One of them. Luke. Oh, makaraba kashanaba. Yeah, baba da baraba. Luke. Mama raba kashan. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, baraba kashanama kasanama. Mama. To your name, O Lord. There's no other name. I love the name. It's Luke 11, beginning at 15, sorry. Yep. Wow. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Come just now.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's Luke chapter 15, beginning at 11. It says, and he said, there was a certain man who had two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the part of the property that falls to me. And he divided the estate between them. And not very many days after that, the young man's son gathered all that he had and journeyed into a distant country. There he wasted his fortune in reckless and loose living. And when he had spent all he had, a mighty famine came upon that country, and he began to fall behind and be in want. So he went and forced himself upon one of the citizens of that country, who sent him to his field to feed pigs, hogs. And he would have gladly have fed on and filled his belly with the cow pot that the hogs were eating, but they could not satisfy his hunger. Nobody gave him anything. Then when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father have enough food and even food to spare, but I am perishing here of hunger. I will get up and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against him, heaven and in your sight, and I am no worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your higher servants. All right? So if you look at the scripture here, the recovery of this guy came from that decision, that simple decision he made, he chose to make. Came from that decision. He made up his mind that he was going back to his father's house, and as he go back to his father's house,
He was not going as a son. He was going as a, he took the responsibility that he had messed it up. He had wasted. He refused counsel. He refused divinity. He took all the responsibility. Now, most times sometimes people come to that realization where they know the mistakes they made, the things they've done are not okay. But then all they do is that they live in regret. It's not just enough to acknowledge that you made a mistake, you did something wrong and you did that. It's also enough that now that this situation that happened have presented this challenge in your life, how do you recover? How do you get out of it? That's why most of the people come to me and they share things and they are so much caught up in it. I say, listen to me, sorry that it happened and I feel bad you had to make these mistakes. But guess what? My focus right now is not the mistake you made. My focus right now is how do you get out of the state? And there are some of you right now that listen to me this morning that you are in a state and to be true, you made a mistake. You caused all the damage. But guess what? You're already there talking about it and blaming yourself and it does not solve the problem. How do you get out of here? How do you change the dynamics? How do you shift things in this place? How do you turn things around and make it better? This young man, he had enough wealth. He got a share of the property. He went, the Bible says he wasted. He knew he wasted. The Bible says when he wasted it, he decided to still manage life. He tried to live a false life and tried to fold himself. And the more he kept doing it, the more he kept reducing. The more he kept going down, the more he kept going down, the more he kept going down. And when you realize that he kept going down instead of going up, he kept decreasing instead of increasing, he had to make a radical shift. He had to do it, a radical shift. There had to be a radical shift. So he shifted radically. And how did he do it? He made up his mind, hey, this is enough. I've gone so low, I can't go lower than this low. You know why? I know it's going to be shameful. It's going to be regretful. I know, yes, people will talk. A lot of things will happen. But guess what? Things were much better over there. I'm going back there. I'm going back there. My lifting, my establishment, my rising up was tied to that place. And I missed something and I can reinvent the wheels. I can change it. I can go back and put things in place. Today, some of you, I mean, some of the things you are going through is because you just made one bad mistake. Sometimes the reason why the marriage didn't work and right now certain things are something, the separation and so is because you never took time to realize that you had some terrible ways, you did some evil things, you were not able to acknowledge your mistakes. All you saw was the mistake of the other person. I'm not saying sometimes, sometimes we have this kind of challenge in marriage, that I don't say sometimes people are not terrible or sometimes there can really be some bad extremes that require complete separation, a complete divorce, which or do those things happen out of the something. It's not a pattern, but they do happen in the world we live in. But I'm telling you, sometimes we don't take time to look at what we've done. We don't take time to look at what we contributed. We don't take time to look at what we caused that led to the damage and the destruction. We don't take time to consider it. We don't take time to pay attention to these things. And guess what? As we don't take time to pay attention to these things, what happens at the end of the day is that we stay in the state. We live in that falsehood. We pretend. We make people believe that things are working and we forget to know that this life we live is working with time. The more you delay time, the more you push things ahead, the more you don't put things in order correct. You see, if you are taking good steps and you make one bad step or one wrong step takes you out of order. Unless you get back on course, you will keep going out of order. No matter how long you walk, because you have gotten off course, the further you walk away from your destiny. Like some of you now, you took one step off and you have kept going. You don't want to come back. Coming back, you feel it will cause you to walk. Coming back will put you back on course to take you to your destination. Not coming back will keep you walking, but walking further away from what you are supposed to achieve. And my prayer for you this morning is that you will come back and get restored and recover and go to where you're supposed to go. So there's a peace you're supposed to have. There's liberty you're supposed to have. There are certain things you're supposed to be experiencing that you're not experiencing right now. Why are you not experiencing? Because you have just chosen that you're not going to correct it. You're not going to correct it. So maybe there's some good relationship you've lost. Some good relationship you have affected. And right now you need to reevaluate and see how you can work at it and get it back on course. Each of us, there are times. Like all the past, that the things I've been looking at, and I believe there are some things I need to rework so that certain things can get back in place, certain things, certain connections, certain attachments. Oh yes, rather because of one or two mistakes, one or two things. Maybe I didn't think straight. I didn't consider that I was supposed to go. So, you know, as a human, you have to do evaluation from time to time. Recovery and restoration in your life is as a result of you as a person recognizing.
You have to recognize. You have to know the challenges you are faced with. You have to know them. And you will have to solve it.
So that you can know it. But some people don't take time to solve it. They feel it's difficult. They fear it's over. They feel that, you know, they take time up with different. I mean, today, I want to say to you, it's not over. I want to say to you, it's not over. I want to say to you, you can make it this morning. I want to say to you, you can change the dynamics. I want to say to you, you can cause something new to break forth. I want to say to you, you can cause the dynamics to shift. Oh, yes. I want to say that to you. And I know it's possible. Yeah. It's possible. Possible as possible. And it's going to happen. Hallelujah. It's going to happen.
Oh, yeah. Somebody listen and say, it's going to happen.
The next thing you need to do,
and that's what I want to talk about tonight, and I'll close,
is that you need to shift your spiritual capacity. Shift your spiritual capacity. Now that you acknowledge that you are God's leader, you are God's deliverer, and then you have also gotten to know the challenges you are faced with and made up your mind that you're going to solve them. To have those things achieved, many of those things are beyond your human capacity. There are some that within your human capacity that you can use your human strength and human will and human wisdom to achieve. And there are some that are beyond you. For those ones, you will have to shift your spiritual capacity. I want you to say to yourself, shift your spiritual capacity. Shifting your spiritual capacity means that you have to change position when it comes to spiritual things. You have to move to another level. There are some of you right now, many of the things you are facing is because you are at a lower spiritual level. You will have to ascend. You will have to transition. You will have to go up. And this morning, I see you going up. I see you transitioning. I see you rising. I see you waking up. I see you taking the bulls by the horn. I see you changing the dynamics because you have decided that, listen, enough is enough. I cannot go through this consistently. I know that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of our strongholds. We cast down imagination, every high thing that want to exalt itself above the knowledge of God, and we bring it into captivity to the obedience of Christ. 2 Corinthians 10:4-6. That's what it says. So there are things automatically that you can handle spiritually. You can bring into subjection. All right. Ephesians 6:12-10. Be strong in the Lord in the power of His might. Put on the entire armor of God that you'll be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. All right? For we rise up not against flesh and blood, but against what? Principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. That's it. Well, TV Psalm 34. I sought the Lord, and He delivered me. When did He deliver me? When I sought Him. I had to shift in my spiritual capacity. And as I shifted and I sought God, He delivered me. Oh, someone is seeking God this morning, and God will deliver you. You are going to seek God. You are going to seek God. Your prayer life is going to shift. You that have been acting slack about prayer. You don't take your prayer life serious. You don't spend time with God. You don't spend time in prayer. Prayer is an option. And when you feel like doing it, when you don't feel like doing it, don't do it. You don't just spend time in prayer. You don't spend time in the Word. You don't meditate in God's Word. You don't get to understand, because God's will is revealed in God's Word. No one can know the will of God if you don't know the Word of God. The Word of God reveals the will of God. The Word of your way becoming prosperous, your way becoming successful is by the Word. And this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, for thou shalt meditate therein day and night, and be careful to obey everything written within it. And with it you shall make your way prosperous, and you shall have what? Good what? Success. So God is saying to you that if he, listen to me, if this will have to happen, you must shift. So making your way prosperous is by the word. And that requires a spiritual shift. If you begin to see the word of God as the white man's book, as somebody's idea, somebody's insight, I say to you, you are living in deception. Somebody have deceived you. Somebody have put you in bondage. Somebody want to scatter and mess you up. And the person have chosen to delude you. And you have accepted that. And you take the word of God, travel it. You don't believe it. You think it's somebody's ideas. Brother, sister, this is God's word. Reading OMP of thousands of years from different locations with no contradictions. And listen to me. 25% of this book includes prophecy, and almost all have been fulfilled. And at the time we were reading, and so many things it spoke about are coming to have come to pass, and it was written at the time they never existed. It was written at the time it was never a reality. All of these things were written in the book. So listen to me. This is God's word that reveals God's mind, that reveals God's will. Oh yes, it's important. And so as you move along, you're going to learn about other things you need to shift. Mentorship, spiritual mentorship. Finding authority, leadership to guide you, to be taught, to train, to build you up, to teach you the rudiments of the kingdom. You know, today you got a lot of half-baked Christians, malnourished Christians, untrained Christians, because they refuse to go to the rudiments of the kingdom, to grow through the status of the kingdom. Someone's supposed to be in nursery, and they go decide that they're going to go to high school and operate at the level of high school when you don't even have nursery lesson correct. I pray God will deliver. I pray that, and listen, some of you, that's what your problem is right now. You are operating at a level that you were not prepared for. You don't have capacity for. And the sooner you realize it and readjust yourself and start from the level you're supposed to start from, I tell you, you will see those dreams, those things that God want to do in your life being fulfilled, being accomplished. Some of you are taking on title. You think ministry is entitled. Instead of going to submit and be trained and develop, you are jumping and taking titles and jumping the thing. You got no business. You just misbehaving and causing problems all around the place because you're not trained. You're not developed. You don't know what you are dealing with. You don't know what you are confronting. And you are just scamming around the place. My prayer for you tonight, or this morning, sorry, is that you will choose to make some readjustment in your decisions so that there can be a divine takeoff. So there's a place of mentorship. There's a place of submitting to mentorship in building your spiritual capacity. So you must build your knowledge base through the word of God. Your knowledge base. Because when you spend time in God's word, your knowledge is increased. And the Bible says a man of knowledge increases in strength. A man of knowledge increases in strength. I see you increase in strength because you are a child of knowledge, because you are a servant of God of knowledge. I see that happen in your life. Hallelujah. Some of you have been hit, you have been struck, you have been betrayed. People have done some terrible things to you. I come to join my faith to you this morning and say, don't give up, don't become bitter. Don't become sour in life. Don't become evil because others are doing evil to you. Remain good. The Bible says, do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. I encourage you to still be a good person. Still be a nice person. Don't be traumatized. Everything that's trying to traumatize you, I set you free. I break the bound. I loose you from the chains. And I speak liberty to your life today. I declare, let the purpose of God be fulfilled concerning you. Let the purpose of God. Oh yes, the purpose of God. Let the purpose of God be fulfilled concerning your life. May you not disappoint God. May you not disappoint your generation. May you leave a mark. May you change the paradigm. May you shift things to the glory of God. This morning, I want to encourage you. When we come tomorrow morning, we're going to spend more time on shifting your spiritual capacity. And we're going to talk about different issues in depth when it comes to shifting your spiritual capacity. This morning, I pray that you will shift your spiritual capacity, that God will grace you, God will strengthen you, God will raise you, God will empower you, yes, to shift your spiritual capacity. God will help you to solve the challenges you are faced with. God will help you to fight the battles of life. God will help you to discover the battles of life. Discover your battle. understand it and be able to properly put it in perspective. You're going to be like Paul, who could say, I have fought a good fight. I have run the race. I have finished my course. I declare to you this morning, you will finish what you were sent here to do. This year, the things you are supposed to accomplish this year, you will accomplish it. Even in the midst of COVID-19, you will still accomplish what you're supposed to accomplish. There will be no delay. I know there have been some things that have happened that want to create some pause and thing in life. Guess what? As we God's transition out of here, there will be divine speed in things. There will be divine restoration. This morning, get ready for a restoration. Some of you are down. You are confused as you listen to me right now. You think you have missed it. God is about to visit you that you will not even remember you had a trouble. You will not even remember you had a crisis in your life. Your life will experience a complete metamorphosis, a complete change, a complete transition that will bring you to a new place in God. I pray this morning for you. Oh God, lift your hands wherever. Father, I thank you this morning. I join my faith, Lord, to my audience, brothers, sisters, families, people that are going through challenges, people, oh God, that need your recovery power. Oh God, you are a recoverer. You are the one who specializes in doing this. This morning, I lift that family. I lift that individual. I lift that situation. I stand in agreement this morning. I come against every work of darkness. He said, behold, it will gather. You say it will not be by you. You say anyone that will rise up against us will fall for our sake. In verse 17, you say, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Lord, today I stand in agreement with your people. Whatever weapon have been raised up, left, right, front, back, from wherever kingdom, I destroy, I break their powers, I destroy their stronghold, I overturn and override their setups and conspiracies on the earth, in the heavens, in hidden and secret places. I overturn by the blood, I scatter by the fire, I nullify in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare and decree this morning, it shall not stand, it shall not work, it cannot succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. It is written in the word of God, whatever my Father has not planted shall be uprooted. This morning, I uproot everything God has not planted. Everything God has not planted, I uproot it. I uproot it out of your life. I uproot it out of your family. I uproot it out of your path. I uproot it out of your environment. I scatter by the blood. Every invasion, intrusion, imposition, I destroy by the blood. I destroy by the fire. I destroy by the anointing. I pray this morning for divine insight, for divine wisdom, for divine guidance. I pray for leadership. You say, Lord, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. I pray that that daughter and that son of Zion, Lord, will begin to be guided and led by you in insight and instruction, that they will find a way, they will find counsel. For you said, in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. Lord, we declare safety for your people. We declare safety for your people. Lord, we pray for this day. Lord, there are some that woke up this morning and they don't even want to face this day. I pray for them this morning. Renew their strength. Restore their joy. Quicken their spirit. Raise them out of every despondency. Lord, change the paradigm. Change the atmosphere over them. Raise them to a new place in you. Cause them to experience newness in your power. I come against the spirit of heaviness. I come against the spirit of heaviness. Every broken spirit, I pray for restoration. I pray your glory be revealed. I pray your power be released. And I thank you for doing a new thing. Oh God, I bless you. I bless you, Lord. Father, this morning on this mountain, I pray for healing. I pray for that brother or sister that is going through that affliction. I pray for them this morning. I speak to the cells, the tissue, the organ, the system, the tendons, the ligaments. I flush their blood with the blood of Jesus. I flush their life with the blood of Jesus. I release healing virtue from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. I say, be healed this morning. Be healing your body. Be healing your spirit. Be healing your soul. Be restored in the name. I speak speedy recovery in the name of Jesus Christ. I cancel every negative report, every evil report over you. I cancel it this morning. And I speak a new day in your life. I speak healing I say, rise out of your bed of affliction. Every wrong spirit following you, I command it to go. Every demonic nightmare, night woman, influencing your life negatively, I break their powers. I command them to lose their hold of you. I set you loose on their conscience. I speak freedom to you. I speak wholeness to you. I speak liberty to you. Everything planted in your environment, released by spells, whatever, I cast it out. I disconnect you from any kingdom by legal attachment and legal ground. I destroy it. It is written, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things have passed away. All things have become new. And God was in Christ, reconciling men to himself and not imputing their sins against them. I pray for your liberty. I activate the power of your new covenant. I enforce it over your life and over your destiny in the name of Jesus. For I thank you. I thank you for liberty. I thank you for freedom. I thank you for freedom. Oh. Let the anointing of God flow this morning. Lord, I release your anointing. I release your anointing. I release your anointing. I release your anointing. I pray for that servant of God, that boy, that girl, that man, that woman, that pastor, that one that is fighting with their walk with you, a challenge in their relationship with you. I pray for restoration. Everyone that have missed it, everyone that have gotten off Tanya, off course, I pray a detour back to normal, back to order. In the name of Jesus, I pray grace and strength, the grace to make decision, the grace to be committed to the decision. I pray for their restoration. Wherever they have lost their fear for you, they have lost their love for you, let there be a restoration this morning. Let fresh dew for heaven, fresh glory for heaven rest upon them. Let it come upon them from the crown of the head to the sole of their feet. Let there be mighty restoration. Let your glory fill their house this morning again. Let it fill it this morning. Let it fill it. Yes, sir, Lord. Yes, sir. It's the worship of the Lamb. We bless you. Hallelujah. Yes, you are holy, this boy. Let your presence make it a bush. Behold, behold, behold,
seated.
Say, I restore to you the years the locusts have eaten.
Worship a little longer.
You can trust him for that. You can depend on him.
Honor his presence.
And
honor his presence.
Close this time of giving the opportunity to
to meet Christ if you haven't met him. And if you listen to me this morning, you haven't met Christ as your Lord and Savior, I'd like to give you the opportunity this morning. You know that he came to this world, he died, not for himself but for our sins. Giving us the opportunity to have access to God, to become God's children. Not just God's creature, but God's children. And if you haven't made that decision, I want to give you the opportunity. I'd like to lift your hands this morning and say, Jesus, Lord, I come to you today. I know you died on Calvary for me. Today I accept your salvation package and I ask you to forgive me. Cleanse me. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and my Savior. I submit to you today and I surrender to you. Thank you, Jesus, for accepting me. In Jesus' name. I want to let you know that you made a great decision. As much as it looks simple, that's a great decision. And this is the beginning of a new walk. And to make that possible, there are some initial things you need to do. Number one, find a good church where you can grow, study the word. But while you're doing that, you need to maintain a personal prayer life with Christ, Jesus, regular prayer. You need to study the word of God. You need to find someone, be a pastor or a spiritual leader that will be able to guide a mentor you in the things of God and begin to commit yourself in your relationship. But these are just beginning minutes. And surround yourself with literatures and materials that will build your life and feed your spirit and your soul wonderful. I want to encourage you concerning that to do it. Because with that, you can rest assured that you're going to grow and you're going to develop in the things of God. Thank you for doing that. You can keep in touch with us. And before we close, our information will be on the screen. You can follow us there, our numbers, and just everything else. Yeah. And those of you who are following us, and one way or the other, you like to partner with us. You know, we run 3 broadcasts every day. We look forward to going to 4, but we want to start with 3 for now. We have the 6:30 to 7:30 in the morning. Then we have the 10 to 11. And then we have the 8 to 9 in the evening. And the early morning is morning dew. The late morning is time of refreshing. That's where we started. And the late night is the bread of 8 to 9 is the bread of life broadcast on our streaming TV. And you can get on Guest Agape Ministries page and some of the other connected pages. If you're on streaming TV page, you have a page on streaming TV. Get that. Also go to our YouTube channel and see whether you can subscribe. We appreciate wherever you're watching this one. Please go to our YouTube channel and subscribe. There are a lot of videos we are uploading. And you can keep building your spirit from there. Faith coming by hearing and hearing the word. We encourage you to do that. God bless you. And you have the right to expand this information and give it to as many persons. Invite them to be a part of this time. It's a way of money. This morning devotion is going to stay consistently until Jesus comes. So we encourage you to begin to encourage people to be a part of it. We've been working and finally it's stable. 6:30 to 7:30. God bless you. Thank you very much. It's been a great time with you this morning. And we know that you will never be the same again. Just in case you will need questions, you need other things. Tomorrow we're doing our best to see how we can have our lines up. And we'll give you our numbers so that you begin following our numbers and other things to the glory of God. God bless you. And take care. Until we meet again, God bless you. And the Frenchman said, dear beings. Yeah. Take care.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church.
To what his word
say.
Let the church,
say,
amen. Ooh, yeah, yeah. Make this. he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body,
amen,
to the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you're feeling,
amen,
or how your world is reeling,
amen,
battle on through the night,
amen,
'cause you're gonna win the fight.
Amen. Let the church say,
let the church say, amen.